Well, it is finally time, everyone. We are back to working on the Lincoln. This big, heavy beast needs to get taken all apart up front, and we're gonna figure out what's going on and figure out our next plan of action for this car. My goodness. First thing we gotta do is get this front bumper off. It is no more usable at all. It is destroyed. Look how far this thing is pushed in. Just give you guys an idea here. Look at that frame rail, and look how far this thing is V'd in right there. That is a good amount. It's pushed all the way in. I mean, we're hitting with the engine at this point. So we gotta get the bumper off. We gotta get the destroyed radiator out of it, because the radiator is split in half. There's the tank, there's the actual radiator split in half right here. Luckily, there's a belt still good on this engine. Hopefully still good when we look at it. Let's get this AC condenser off. Let's yank the whole core support back out straight and check all of our wiring connections, spark plugs, everything else behind the radiator that's been crushed, make sure it's still okay, and see if we can find out what's going on with the oil leak and transmission leak underneath it. And then once we've diagnosed what's currently wrong with the car, we will see if this engine is still manageable and salvageable to fire up, see if we can get it to run, and if it does still run okay, then we're gonna go through the process of getting this thing repaired up front. The frame rails are completely straight on both sides, guys. This thing's all cosmetic. It's all body damage. So we're going to have to pull the core support back out. We'll get a fresh bumper on it, fresh radiator put in it, and whatever else we can do to tie this thing together. And we'll go run this car again. We're going to keep running it forwards until this thing's destroyed. There's virtually no back end left on this car. So we're just going to go forwards and see how much abuse this car could finally take until we find a way to break it beyond repair. But pulling off this bumper is going to be a bit harder than I originally thought. And the issue is, this bumper has flattened so far back in here that the bolts to bolt the bumper on have crushed through the bumper. And actually, here's one of the bolts. It is stabbing through my bumper. That was not supposed to be there. That is actually bolted to the plate on my car. It went through the backing of the bumper and through the outer core of the bumper, stabbed all the way through it. And that is what left of one of my bolts. The other ones are all behind this entire piece, and the same thing happened on this side, completely flattened all back in here. So the only way to get to those bolts to cut everything off is to cut a big square and remove the front skin of this bumper so I can see the inner skin of this bumper and hopefully see where the bolts are to hack them completely off, and this bumper should fall off at that point. Then we're going to have to come up with a new way to get bolts onto that backing plate. I don't even know how straight those backing plates are. We need to check those out. If they're all twisted and mangled, we may need to put new backing plates on this. So we'll get those put on there. That's step number one. And then once we get this thing pulled out, we're going to turn the camera back on to find out what kind of damage is going on behind this core support. Remember, this car did still start up and run. It drove off the trailer and into this barn. Oh, long ago. This has been over a year ago, guys, since we have started this car, and this thing has been in a derby. So it's been sitting for quite some time. That's why we're going to make sure this thing does still start and nothing else has gone bad on it while it's been sitting. The good news is all of the tires on it are still holding air, so that's cool. We don't need to make any new tires. We do got to watch out for this flap, though. It has a pretty considerable chunk missing out of it. We may put new flaps on this. I'm not sure yet. And there's a look at the frame. If you guys don't remember this car, there's the front frame still straight on this thing, and the unibody frame under it, very beastly, holding up. So that's why I'm going to go through the effort of fixing this. As long as it runs good, it has a great front frame. But all right, I'm going to tear into it and let's see if we can get this bumper off.